गुड मॉर्निंग। सो फर्स्ट वील सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 56। सो वी आर सेइंग फोर्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ टाइम एट एनी पॉइंट टाइम टी मेजर्ड एंड वट एवर। कैलकुलेट द एक्यूमुलेशन एट टाइम 10 of 500 invested at time 0. So, and in the second part we have continuous payment stream. So we might have a question of single payment or we might have question of continuous payment stream. So for single payment, our accumulation or our future value must be equal to our 500 into e raised to integration of our delta s ds, and we'll be going from time 0 to time 10. So I'll do the integration separately and say integration, I'll have to go from 0 to 8. Maybe I made some mistake because the answer is 841 and I'm getting 586. Okay, here it should be 52. So this was the easy one. Now we'll talk about the second part. The second part say calculate the present value at time zero of a continuous payment stream at the rate of 200 e raised to 0.1 t paid from time 10 to 18 and do it here. So our payment stream rho t is given as 200 e raised to 0.1 t from time 10 to 18. Now remember this, they'll always give you your payment stream when we have a constant rate of interest. You can see from 10 to 18, we definitely have a constant rate of interest. Now, this would be nothing but our present value will be equal to our integration rho t e raised to minus integration delta s ds and then dt. This is our formula where our first integration will always have rho t's limits. So that goes from 10 to 18. And the second one will always have 1t. Where do we have 1t? So first of all, we'll know where to go. In this case, we are going to time 0. So 0 and the other must be t. Now our integration 0 to t delta s ds, we have two different integrations from 0 to 8 and from 8 to t, where t will always be between 10 to 18 because t comes from rho t. Okay, so t will always be between 10 to 18. So we can go from any value. Let's assume that we are talking about something 12, from 12 to 8. So t is always between 10 to 18. So we'll have 8 to 0. But t comes greater than 8. Okay. So 8 se lekar koi bhi value tak ke, wherever we are talking about, our t might be. Now this division comes from the division of our delta t. Okay, because delta t ke do division hai, t less than 8 and t greater than 8. Uske hisab se ye hamare division bane. Okay. But remember, yahan par hum logon ne t lene ki jagah s le liya hai. Just because we do not want us to confuse two different t's. So this is s. This is delta s. So these values must be s. So ye jo hai, ye s ke limits hai. S less than 8, s greater than 8. T ke limits kya rahenge? T ke limits will be this. 10 to 18. So, ye wala part pehle solve kar chuke, that is this. So, we will not do it again. Ye wala part karna padega. So, we'll have integration 8 to t 0.06 ds. That would give us 48. So this is what we are getting. So finally, we'll have our present value is equal to integration from 10 to 18 and rho t is 200 e raised to 0.1 t, and then we'll have e raised to minus 0.4 plus 0.06 t minus 0.48 and then dt. सो क्या क्या बाहर निकाल सकते हैं, 200 बाहर निकाल सकते हैं, एंड ये ई रेस टू माइनस 0.4 एंड दिस बिकम्स प्लस 0.48. सो इन एक्चुअलिटी वी विल हैव 200 ई रेस टू 0.08 ये बाहर, एंड देन इंटीग्रेशन 10 टू 18 विल कंबाइन दिस 0.01 एंड ये वाला जो है विल हैव ई रेस टू 0.04 टी हो जाएगा डीटी. We are getting 3047.3326. Use this concept and the others 57, 58, 59, these are homework. And I think we have more such questions here. Yes, 60, 61, 62. You can see lagatar we have the same type of questions because these are very common questions in our examination. We definitely get one question. So, ये होमवर्क है, so करते जाना एंड देन कुछ डाउट्स रहेंगे तो वील मूव यू नो वील बी सॉल्विंग इट एवरी सिंगल डे. नाउ 7.7 वाज आल्सो अ डाउट, वील सी दैट. फोर्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, calculate the accumulated value at time 10 of a continuous payment stream that is received from time 4 to time 8 under which the rate of payment is this. Now see, this kind of question is one of the unique ones. Okay, so it's a very good question. जैसे मैंने हमेशा बोला हुआ है, जैसे यहाँ पर भी बोला था कि R पेमेंट स्ट्रीम ये जो 200 ई रेस टू 0.1 टी था दैट विल ऑलवेज बी व्हेन वी हैव अ कांस्टेंट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, कांस्टेंट फोर्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट. यहाँ पे 0.06 था बट यहाँ पे यू कैन सी वी डू नॉट हैव एनी कांस्टेंट फोर्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एंड ये भी अजीब सी वैल्यूज है. नाउ व्हेनेवर यू हैव सच क्वेश्चन ऑलवेज रिमेंबर वील हैव टू यूज सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड because there is no other way to solve the integration. So substitution method se hi karna pade. So we need to find accumulation. So our future value at time 10 will be integration again. We'll have our rho t e raised to integration delta s ds dt. Because future value, that is why ye positive ho gaya, e raised to positive value. Now again limits, rho t will always have limits of rho t. So rho t ke limits are 4 to 8. And dusra wala, from where to where. So we are going to time 10. We know that. So final value is time 10 and we'll be going from t. One of them will always be t. Whenever we have rho t, this is how we'll write it. Okay. Next, we'll make our equation. So we'll have integration 4 to 8, 0.3 plus 1.5 t. And then e raised to integration t to 10. We can do this पहले e delta s को पहले solve कर सकते हैं, तो integration T to 10, we'll have 0.01 plus 0.05 S ds ये 10 डाला तो 2.6 एंड टी डालेंगे तो विल जस्ट राइट इट 0.01 टी प्लस 0. प्लस का ये भी माइनस हो जाएगा माइनस 0.025 टी स्क्वायर. एल सब्स्टिट्यूट दैट सो माय फ्यूचर वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशन 4 to 8 and here we'll have our 0.3 plus 1.5 t e raised to 2.6 minus and bracket mein write 0.01 t minus 0.025 t square and then dt. So ये e raised to 2.6 तो हम लोग बाहर निकाल सकते हैं that is constant. Now we'll have to solve this e raised to minus this term. As I told you that we'll be using substitution method. Substitution method में we will take this as our t or as whatever we need to substitute. So I'll say 0.01 t minus 0.025 t square must be equal to u. We substitute करने वाले हैं. So we'll have to find what will be our dt in terms of du or du in terms of dt. So we'll differentiate and we'll get 0.01. ये minus नहीं है plus है because this is plus. ठीक है यहाँ से minus sign बाहर निकाला था bracket में so I would get this as plus. So we'll get minus plus 0.05 t. This dt will be equal to du. So now यहाँ पे you can see I need this term to make du. ये term and ये term you can see are very similar. The difference is if I take 3 out and divide this by 10, I will get this term. So all I have to do is make this into this term. So uske liye 3 bahar nikalunga and I'll have to divide by 10. That means 30 agar main bahar nikalta hu. So so 30 agar main bahar nikalta hu yahan pe and ye e raised to 2.6 bahar nikalta hu. So I'll be left with integration. I'll not put the limits right now. Okay, I'll put first 4 to 8. I'll have 0.01 plus 0.05 t e raised to minus 0.01 t plus 0.025 t square and then dt. Okay. So this term becomes my u, this into dt becomes my du. We are getting 30 e raised to 2.6 integration. I will have e raised to minus u du. I will not put the limits right now. I'll resubstitute it into t and only then I'll put the limits. So you have e raised to minus u upon minus 1. Now I will substitute it back. Now I'll put the limits 4 to 8. This into 30 into e raised to 2.6. So our answer is 184.855. I hope that was the answer. Yes, so final answer is 184.855. So remember, yeah, you can see here they have done the same thing, substitution method. I don't know what was the first method that they did, but I don't want to go into, because always take one method that you know well and do not go for any other method. So for any sum where you can directly see that we do not have our continuous rate of interest and we still have our rho t as a function of time, then you know that there must be a substitution method. Otherwise, it will not be able to solve. Okay. So, ye wala type ka question is a unique question. Ye aaya hai ek bar in the examination and only once. Okay. So, this is exactly the same sum that came in the examination. Okay. And iske alawa kabhi is type ka sum nahi aaya. I think we have this sum in our assignment as well. ये है या इस टाइप का है, नॉट वेरी श्योर, बट मे बी नॉट एग्जैक्टली द सेम सम, बट इसी टाइप का एक सम है. यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हेन यू कम अप विद दैट सम. सो वी विल मूव ऑन टू आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर. ये चैप्टर का ये प्रैक्टिस करना बहुत जरूरी है. एंड The thing is, integration is chapter ke baad bahut rarely use hota hai. We don't use it much. But definitely other subjects will use a lot of integration. So you cannot assume that ki we will not be using integration a lot. Just will not be using it in this course. Okay, we'll be using it in other subjects. Then we'll talk about level annuities. Now, abhi tak ke, this is our chapter 8, level annuities. Now, first of all, what is an annuity? Now, annuity is nothing but an installment. Level just means that we are talking about they are exactly same. Okay. So level annuity just means that we have same installments. Now we have seen EMI. EMI is a level annuity. We say they are nothing but equal monthly installments. Okay. So they are equal, they are monthly, and they are installments. So that is nothing but a type of annuity. Although we'll not be seeing monthly right now, we'll be first looking at yearly installments. Okay. So the annuity term just means it is installments. Okay. Level annuity means that they are going to be same. Now these are the different symbols that we are going to be using. Okay, you can see that ye jo hai, ye jo N ke upar symbol hai, that is called as annuity angle. Okay. So this is specially made for annuities. So I'll be talking about what is A, what is S, then wo P and ye jo signs hai, ye sab cheeze baat karunga in a minute. But remember, this is a subscript. So when I say A and N, I'm saying this N is in a subscript. Okay, with this annuity angle. Now, ये सारे terms तो हम लोगों को पता है, okay? So आज तो ठीक है, but कल again सारे के सारे चीजें ये करके आना, revise करके आना पहले के, because these are very much important to us right now. Now, when we talk about payments, annuity payments की अगर हम लोग बात करें, so we have three types of payments. We can have payments at the beginning of the year. We can have payments at the end of the year. And we can have payments continuously throughout the year. So, we are talking about our installments. I can pay installments either at the beginning of the year, or I can pay installments at the end of the year, or I can pay continuously throughout the year. We'll talk about all those three options. Now, when we talk about at the beginning of the year, we say it is advance, or another name is due. These are the two names that we give to payments that are at the beginning of the year. At the end of the year, we say it is arrears or certain. And this is by default the term that we take. We assume by default that the payments are at the end of the year. And continuously, kill aur koi naam nahi hai, we just say continuously. So, अब सिंपल सी बात है कि इफ यू टेक लोन यू विल बी पेइंग सम टाइम. ओके, वो जो टाइम पीरियड रहेगा, कौन से टाइम पे तुम पे करोगे? एवरी मंथ यू पे एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ द मंथ, और यू पे एट द एंड ऑफ द मंथ. इस टाइप से यू हैव अ पर्टिकुलर टाइम पीरियड व्हेन यू आर पेइंग योर इंस्टॉलमेंट. सो यहाँ पर हम लोग इयरली इंस्टॉलमेंट्स की बात कर रहे हैं स्टार्टिंग में, दैट इज व्हाई वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ द ईयर, और वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट एट द एंड ऑफ द ईयर. So we have three kinds of payments. Now, level annuities ke we can calculate either present value or we can calculate our future value. First, we'll be talking about present value.
Hi Pranay, I had a question, if you don't mind.
Haan, puchho na.
So why is the, you know, annuity payment at the end or in arrears also called certain? Because that is the only one that can be uncertain, right? If something happens in between, you know, the somebody dies or whatever.
I'll talk about that. Certain does not actually mean at the end of the year. Certain means everything is known. Okay. So certain means that the payment, how, what are the value of the payment? So level bola hua hai, to we know beforehand ki how much do we have to pay, when do we have to pay, and for how many years we'll have to pay. So that is what certain actually means. So in actuality, certain does not mean arrears, but by default, our payments are in arrears. That is why if we get the term certain, we assume it is going to be arrears. Okay.
Okay. Understood. Thank you. Okay.
So the certain term is just because everything is known. Everything is certain. चलो present value की बात करते हैं ना. Present value, the first term we are going to take is going to be the payment are at the beginning of the year, that we'll call it as advance. So we say payment in advance. Now the symbol for that is our A due N. Now this A is for present value. Okay. Small a jo hai, that is for present value. Due is for advance or due, whatever. Theek hai, wo symbol ko due kehte hai, two dots. Okay. So due, and N is number of payments or number of years of payments. Number of years. So this is the symbol. Okay. A is for present value, represents that we are calculating present value. That two dots are the symbol of due or advance. The payments are in advance. And N is how many number of years of payments are we talking about? So this A due N, iska definition likh lenge, we'll say present value of so let's continue. Okay, so present value of an annuity of ₹1 paid at the beginning of each year for N years. So the symbol A represents present value. Due represents that the payments are at the beginning of the year, and N represents the number of years. Now we'll talk about how to find this value. So we are talking about, we'll draw a number line. So we are saying the payments are at the beginning of the year. So the first payment and ₹1 is le bola hua hai, because then we can multiply any value to get our final answer. 500 ka payment hai, we'll just multiply 500 here and we'll get our answer. Okay, so we'll find for ₹1 and we'll just multiply the value. So at the beginning of first year, the payment will be at time zero. At the beginning of second year, the payment will be at time one. At the beginning of third year, the payment will be at time two. Okay, remember, end of the first year and beginning of the second year is basically the same time. Okay, 31st December, raat ke 12 baje, 12 a.m. bolo ya p.m. bolo, I'm not sure what will that be called. And 1st Jan, raat ke 12 baje, is basically the same time. Okay. So beginning of the next year and end of this year is basically the same time. Okay. So when I'm saying beginning of the second year, it is end of the first year. It's time one. Similarly, beginning of the fourth year and beginning of the last year is going to be at time n minus one. So, ab iske agar mujhe present value nikalni hai, So I'll say I will be discounting each and every value to time one, and then I will adding, I will be adding them. So first wala payment is already at time one. Second wala payment ko I'll have to discount for 1 year. Third wala payment ko I will have to discount for 2 years. Fourth wala payment ko I'll have to discount for 3 years, and so on. Last payment ko I will have to discount for n minus 1 years. So remember, this small v is nothing but discounting factor for 1 year. Small v we said was 1 by 1 plus I or 1 minus d, or in terms of delta we'll have e raised to minus delta. So it can be any one of these, does not matter. It's just easier for us to write equations with small v rather than writing it in terms of 1 plus I or 1 minus d or e raised to minus delta. That is why we use the small v, just for the sake of convenience. Now if you look at the equation, you can say that this is nothing but a geometric progression. And geometric progression, we know the formula, or I'll just write for say GP yahan pe. GP is nothing but AR square AR cube till last value will be AR raised to n minus 1. These are n terms. First term is A and ratio is R. So isme hum log sum of GP bolenge, or sum of n terms will be equal to 1 minus A into 1 minus R raised to N upon 1 minus R. We say if R is less than 1, and we say A into R raised to N minus 1 upon R minus 1 if R is greater than 1. What happens if R is equal to 1? What happens if R is equal to 1? Any guesses?
Then it's just N times A, because it's A.
Correct. When R will be 1, rather than, you know, going into any formulas, because these formulas are made for specifically R less than 1, R greater than 1. We cannot use these formulas when we talk about R equal to 1. Our denominator will be 0. Okay. So for R equal to 1, we'll go back to our original series. Here, if I put R is equals to 1, each term is going to be A. So I am adding n times A. So we'll have n times A. People do make a mistake here. It's such a simple concept, but people do make a mistake because we do not study this. Iske alawa, we have infinite terms also. We'll be using that later on. But if we have infinite terms, S infinity, we say it will be A upon 1 minus R. Okay, where R should be less than 1. Actually, R should be between minus 1 and 1. I'll just write that. Minus 1 and 1. Okay. So these are the different terms of GP, the different formulas of GP that we'll be using. So back to our present value. This is geometric progression. So GP, where our ratio must be V and our first term will be 1. So accordingly, we'll have V is less than 1, because we say V is equals to 1 upon 1 plus I. I will always be positive. So 1 plus I becomes greater than 1. So 1 upon 1 plus I will be less than 1. So we'll have 1 minus V raised to N upon 1 minus V. If you remember the table, our 1 minus V is nothing but D. Okay. We drew a table of conversion of all of them. Usme 1 minus V is nothing but D. So this becomes our A du N ka formula. That would be 1 minus V raised to N upon D. Again, formulas are very much important. We'll be using them a lot. This becomes basis of everything that you are going to learn in finance in future. आगे के जितने भी financial related subject है, उसमें ये annuity definitely आएगा ही. So, and move forward. Next, we'll be talking about arrears. Arrears means payments are at the end of the year. So, uske liye if I draw the timeline, so I'll say end of the first year mein payment will be at time one. End of the second year mein payment will be at time two. End of the third year mein payment will be at time three. And end of the last year mein payment will be at time n. So my present value, I'll have to discount first payment for 1 year, second payment for 2 years, third payment for 3 years, and so on. So I'll say first payment will be V, then V square, then V cube, and so on till our last payment becomes V raised to n. Again, we'll be using GP, where our first term here is V and our ratio is also V. So this becomes V into 1 minus V raised to n upon 1 minus V. Now we would prefer to keep our numerator same. So what I'll do is I'll keep 1 minus V raised to n as it is, and I'll take this V in the denominator. So denominator becomes 1 minus V upon V. Numerator is nothing but denominator of the denominator. So 1 minus V by V, again, if you remember our table, अच्छा arrears का symbol पहले लिख देता हूँ. Arrears का symbol is AN. Okay, so there is no symbol for arrears, special symbol नहीं है. By default, present value of annuity for n years, we'll be taking it as arrears. So इसलिए there is no special symbol for arrears. So we'll say our AN will be equal to 1 minus V raised to n upon I. This becomes our second symbol. The only difference in the definition that we wrote here, ye ADUN ka, the only difference will be the payment will be at the end of each year. Itna sa difference hai. So that is why I did not write it again. Okay. So you can write that if you want to. Definition for payment in arrears or this AN. We'll have present value of an annuity of rupees 1 paid at the end of each year for n years. Now we'll talk about continuous. Now in the last chapter we talked about this, that in actuality payment in continuous is not practically possible, but very frequent payments can be taken into as continuous payments, like daily payments, weekly payments, we consider them as continuous. Monthly payments we do not consider them as continuous because unke beech mein time difference kafi zyada hai, and we literally have only 12 payments in 1 year then. Okay. But whereas daily payments, we have 365 payments in a year, and weekly payments, we have 52 payments in a year. Versus, we're continuously assume karte hain, to difference between the interest that we are going to get is not much. So we can ignore that small differences so that it becomes convenient for us to solve. So continuous payments is nothing but kya bolte, not practically possible, but we use it a lot for daily payments or weekly payments. Now in your examination, they'll directly say payments are continuous. Okay, so when you're considering it, you assume the payments to be continuous. Like let's say that in an insurance company, you're assuming that every day five people will buy your insurance policy. So if five people are buying your insurance policy of premium, let's say is 1000 rupees. So you know that 5000 rupees daily ka tumhara jo hai income. Okay. So 5000 rupees daily ka income hai. So rather than assuming ki, you know, daily payments and calculating the values, what you will do is you will assume continuous payments. The continuous payments will always be given in per annum basis. So if 5000 daily payment tha, in actuality you will say this much, 5000 into 365 must be your yearly payment. So jitna bhi ho jayega. Five into five, 1825000 per annum. So our continuous payment, jo roti diya rahega, that will always be given in per annum basis. They will never give you in any other units. They will not say daily payment, or even if they say daily payments, we'll have to use it in per annum basis. We'll talk about that later on. Keep up. Present value of annuity and present value of arrears mein kaun sa bada hai, kaun sa chota hai, but you are correct. Present value of annuity at the beginning of the year will be greater than present value of kya bolte ye arrears. Okay, so we'll talk about that. Theek hai, hum log actual mein sum solve karke we'll discuss those things. So roti will always be written in per annum basis. So even if the question says 5000 rupees per day, we'll have to convert it into per annum for solving purposes. So yahan pe I'll say a bar n will be bar. Okay, so usko bolte a bar n bolte. So we'll say present value of an annuity of rupees 1 per annum. Now even though baki dono mein we did not write per annum, but because the payment were once every year, it was automatically per annum. But yahan pe hum log likhte hain continuous ke liye, we always write. So rupees per annum paid continuously throughout the year. For n years. You paid continuously throughout the year for n years. Uska timeline kaise banega? Now, continuously ke liye, there is no direct way of making it into the timeline. Beginning of the year we can say, you know, we can show big, end of the year we can show, but continuously we cannot show it directly on the timeline. But what I prefer is writing it in the middle. So 1 1 1 1. So this shows, at least for us, we know that this means we are talking about continuously throughout the year. Okay. So this timeline is basically for us to understand, not for anyone else. So we don't have to worry too much about it. Present value, we'll be saying integration. We are going 0 to n, our roti. We are paying continuously for 0 to n years. And then we'll have e raised to minus delta t dt. Now I have not taken integration because delta is constant, so directly delta t ho jayega. Okay, ya fir actual mein likhna hai to integration, we'll have our delta into dt or delta into ds. We are assuming delta to be constant. Okay, hamara yahan par assumption hai कि हमारा पेमेंट तो लेवल है ही है, बट ऑल्सो आर रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट और आर फोर्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज कॉन्स्टेंट. So we'll be going to time zero from time t. So this becomes nothing but delta t. So we'll have integration 0 to n. Rho t is 1 e raised to minus delta t dt. When we substitute the values, we'll get 1 minus e raised to minus delta t by delta. Okay, lower limit tha, to lower limit must be negative, but denominator mein we had negative sign, so usko use kar liya. Okay. Now e raised to minus delta is nothing but v. We just talked about it starting mein. Okay. So I'll substitute that and I'll get my a bar n is 1 minus v raised to n upon delta. Now you can see, I'll write down the others as well. We had a du n 1 minus v raised to n by d, and we had a n that was 1 minus v raised to n by I. You can see the pattern. And we'll see this pattern a lot. So we'll see this pattern a lot, that advance mein denominator becomes D, arrears mein denominator becomes I, and continuous mein denominator becomes delta. And this is usually the only difference in our formulas. It becomes easier for us to remember this formula. So by any chance you have studied annuities before and you've feel like whatever you studied is easier for you to remember, don't do that. Okay. Remember these formulas, because we'll be using this pattern a lot. Okay. So it becomes easier for us to remember the formulas. I'll just take an example, or let's say a question. We'll say a loan of 11 installments of ₹5,000 per annum for 10 years, paid. So we have three options. First will be in advance. Second would be in arrears. And third would be continuously. Find the present value. So clearly first wala advance lenge, so we'll be using advance ka formula. So our present value will be nothing but our 5000 a due 10 years ke liye. Now interest rate ne liya, I'll say I is equals to 9%. Now I is equals to 9%, we require D. So we'll find our D. D must be equal to I upon 1 plus I. So I'll say 0.09 divided by 1.09. This becomes our D. Our D is 0.08 0.08 25688. We'll use as many decimal points as we can, but at least 6 decimal points. Okay, whenever we are using calculations ke liye, we should use at least 6 decimal points. So our formula, 5000, 1 minus. Now see what happens is ki v ke liye, jaise v wala we said it is 1 by 1 plus I, or it is 1 minus d, or it is e raised to minus delta. You can use any one of them, does not matter, because we saw you can convert one into the other. Okay, so there is no restriction in what you are using for v or what you are using in your actual formula. So yahan par you can write it in terms of 1 minus d raised to 10 bol sakte ho, or you can say it is 1 plus I raised to minus 10, does not matter. Okay, or you can say it is e raised to minus delta into 10. That is basically the same thing. What we prefer is jo bhi value di hui hai uske terms mein hum log likhenge. It's just easier to calculate. So I'll say this becomes 1 plus I raised to minus 10. Okay, I'll be using that in terms of kya bolte ye jab hum log calculator mein use karenge. Right now I'll just write v raised to 10 by d. So यहाँ पे ये d आ गया है. d को मैं फिर से नहीं use करने वाला हूँ. So I'll just use it as an answer. So I'll say 5000 into यहाँ पे 1 minus bracket में I'll say 1.09 1 plus I bracket close raised to minus of 10. So v की जगह पे I'm using 1 plus I raised to minus 1. Upon d, d ke liye maine answer use kar liya, and we have 2nd wale mein present value will be 5810. Formula. Now, whenever we are using, we are solving a sum from a particular chapter, we'll definitely write down the formulas of that particular chapter. Okay, kam se kam us chapter ke formulas likhna bahut zaruri hai. Again, 5000 into, we'll have 1 minus. And then 1.09 raised to minus 10, and then denominator may will require I, so 0.09. This becomes our present value in arrears, 32,088. Third, we'll require delta. This is 1 minus v raised to 10 by delta. This is our formula. So delta nikalne ke liye, again we'll use I to find our delta. Our delta ka formula is nothing but log of 1 plus I. So ye hamara delta, so present value. Again, 1 minus 1.09 raised to minus 10. Numerator remains same. And denominator may, I'll take answer, delta. So 33511. Now you can see clearly the only difference in all three of these cases was that in the first one we had in advance, in the second one in arrears, and in the third one we have in continuous. Baki koi difference nahi tha question mein. Rate of interest was same. Annuity amount was same. Number of years were same. So in all three of them, the only difference was when did we do that payment. And you can see the difference. So this present value is clearly for you'll say for everything else same, our ADUN will be greater than our A bar N, that would be greater than our AN. This will always be the case. This will always be the case. Now, why is that? So timeline, tino ka timeline alag se bana leta, rather than going up and finding that. This is our advance ka timeline. This is our continuous timeline. This is our arrears timeline. Now in each one of them, we are getting N payments in N years. N payments mil rahe of rupees 1. Yahan pe kya ho raha hai? यहाँ पे द पेमेंट्स का पोजिशन आर वन ईयर बोल सकते हो क्लोजर टुवर्ड्स जीरो देन यहाँ पर जो पेमेंट्स है. सो यू कैन सी अरियर्स के जो पेमेंट्स वर्सेस एडवांस के पेमेंट्स. सो एडवांस में ईच ऑफ दोस पेमेंट्स आर वन ईयर क्लोजर. सो वन ईयर क्लोजर मतलब एक साल कम डिस्काउंट करना पड़ेगा. एक साल कम डिस्काउंट करना पड़ेगा तो ऑटोमेटिकली द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू बिकम्स हायर. The present value of advance is higher than present value of arrears by exactly one factor of discounting factor. Okay, so isiliye jab hamara formula bhi ban raha tha, advance mein we had 1 minus v raised to n upon 1 minus v, and for arrears we had v into 1 minus v raised to n upon 1 minus v. Okay, so jab formula ban raha tha, to we had one discounting factor more. Because we'll have to discount for one more year extra in arrears than in advance. And continuous, you can assume that continuous is like we are paying at the middle of the year. It is not mathematically the same, but we can assume that for the theoretical purposes, that the payments are exactly at the middle of the year. Okay. So that is why we'll have to discount them more than advance, but less than arrears. And that is why advance, ये continuous का payment जो है, that is in the middle. Clear है? So next we'll be seeing our future values. यहाँ पे हमने प्रेजेंट वैल्यूज निकाला. व्हाट इफ वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट फ्यूचर वैल्यूज. सिंपल सी बात है, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट लोन्स वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट प्रेजेंट वैल्यूज, बिकॉज अ लोन अमाउंट इज नथिंग बट द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू. सो इफ आई से दैट यू हैड अ लोन दैट वुड बी रीपेड बाय 5000 पर ईयर फॉर 10 ईयर्स, पेड इन एडवांस, एडवांस में अगर तुम लोन का ईएमआई पे कर रहे हो या पर एनम वाला जो इंस्टॉलमेंट है वो पे कर रहे हो, तो द लोन अमाउंट दैट यू टुक वुड बी इट्स प्रेजेंट वैल्यू. सो दिस मच इज योर लोन अमाउंट. सेम तरीके से अरियर्स में अगर पेमेंट कर रहे हो तो दिस मच इज योर लोन अमाउंट, एंड कंटिन्यूस में अगर पे कर रहे हो दिस मच इज योर लोन अमाउंट. ठीक है, बट यूजुअली व्हाट हैपेंस इज पेमेंट्स आर इन अरियर्स, बिकॉज क्या होगा कि एज सून एज यू टुक अ लोन, लोन कब लोगे, टाइम जीरो पे लोगे. टाइम जीरो पे लोन लेने के बाद इमीडिएटली यू विल नॉट बी पेइंग योर फर्स्ट इंस्टॉलमेंट. दैट डज नॉट मेक सेंस. आई कैन नॉट आस्क यू to you know, let's say you are asking me for loan, I'll give you this 34,976 rupees and then say immediately give me 5,000 rupees. So that does not make sense. Okay, so that is why what happens is loan ke payments usually are in arrears. That does not mean question cannot be made ki loan ke payments are you know in advance. You will find a lot of questions जिनमें बोला जाएगा कि लोन के पेमेंट्स आर इन एडवांस, बट बाय डिफॉल्ट लोन के पेमेंट्स आर इन अरियर्स. Obviously continuously तो हो भी सकते हैं. अगर हम लोग बोल रहे हैं तुम लोन पेमेंट एवरी सिंगल डे कर रहे हो तो वी कैन अज्यूम इट टू बी कंटिन्यूस. सो अभी फ्यूचर वैल्यू वाले क्वेश्चन हम टॉपिक हम लोग बाद में करेंगे. आई विल गिव यू सम होमवर्क. एक्चुअल में हमारा जो असाइनमेंट है असाइनमेंट में यू विल सी यू हैव अ सेपरेट सेक्शन प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ एन्यूटी, बट दिस हैज मोर कॉन्सेप्ट्स देन व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड. सो उसमें से अभी नहीं सॉल्व करेंगे, वी विल बी सॉल्विंग फ्रॉम द बुक. I gave you homework, the other questions as homework as well, जो assignment में से थे. Otherwise, after that, ये question number, page number 225 of this PDF, ठीक है, 225 of this PDF में हमारा present value section चालू होता है. ठीक है, you will see this. डेरिवेशन जो हम लोगों ने किया था, नाउ दिस डेरिवेशन इज कॉल्ड एज फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल. ओके, सो द कैलकुलेट यू नो डेरिवेशन करने का तरीका इज कॉल्ड एज फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल, एंड समटाइम्स दे डू आस्क यू इन द एग्जामिनेशन टू शो अ पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मूला बाय यूजिंग फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल. आवर फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल इज व्हाट वी स्टडीड इन आवर लास्ट चैप्टर, दैट वी विल डिस्काउंट ईच एंड एवरी वैल्यू up to the point and then add them up. So making this equation is called as our first principle. So payment made in advance. Now har ek topic ke baad you will see a particular question. Okay, so ye payment in arrears hai, uske baad ye question hai. Then payment in advance likha hua hai and then uske baad ek question hai. Then accumulation वाला पार्ट तो अभी नहीं. सो ये क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करना है. आई थिंक दो ही क्वेश्चन है, ये दोनों क्वेश्चन भी होमवर्क है. यू अंडरस्टैंड द लैंग्वेज ऑफ द क्वेश्चन, सो इट बिकम्स इजियर फॉर अस टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दे आर आस्किंग. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो ओके, Now by any chance if you see another term, जैसे हम लोगों ने यहाँ पर arrears के लिए we wrote two terms, we had end of the year of payment के लिए we had two terms, we had arrears and we have certain, there is another term that is immediate, that is used again for arrears. Now in actuality immediate again does not mean arrears, but because of the default annuity, it is used as arrears. Okay. Immediate ka just matlab hota hai, there is no time gap. That means I gave you loan at time zero. So your payment starts within the first year, whatever, beginning of the year, end of the year, whatever. Your payment starts within the first year, and it is not, we are not waiting for, let's say, 5 years to start our payments. Ho sakta hai kabhi kabhi, jaise agar tumne loan liya ho for education loan mein kya hoga? After you have completed your education, let's say 3 year ka education tha, after you have completed your education, then your loan payment will start. So ye kya ho gaya? Gap ho gaya of 3 years. So it did not start immediately. So the term immediate means arrears, ye dhyan rakhna hai. Okay. Chalo. I don't think ki yahan par immediate word use kiya hua hai, but yaad rakhna. Now the we'll end our class here. If you have any doubts, isme WhatsApp pe pooch lena, or you can ask me tomorrow at the beginning. Okay. Bye.
Thank you very much.